Congratulations on the purchase of your new Kvant laser projector. Before we get started, we highly recommend watching the How to Safely Set Up Your Laser Projector video first to understand the safety concerns with operating a laser projector. Now, in this video, we'll be showing you how to set up and get your laser to run automatically. The first thing you'll need to do is open the case and pull out the laser projector, along with all the cables and accessories. Inside the case, you should find your projector, TrueCon power cable, Ethernet cable, 3-pin XLR cable, e-stop button, keys, and the user interlock. Moving forward, we're going to start by using the 3-pin XLR cable to connect from the e-stop remote to the laser projector, connecting one end to the laser and the other into the remote. Next, grab the user interlock from the plastic bag and plug it into the e-stop remote. Then, grab the keys and plug one set into the e-stop and the other into the laser projector. We will now take the TrueCon power cable and plug it into the projector and plug the other end into the mains. Lastly, we'll pull up on the e-stop button to reveal the yellow stripe. Then press the start button until both LEDs turn on. This will turn on similar LEDs found on the back side of the projector. To be sure everything is set up correctly, the following LEDs should be illuminated: power, start, and the FP4 controller on the back of the laser should be a static green. If all these LEDs are shown, the projector is now powered and ready to be controlled. Here's something to remember when working with multiple Kvant laser projectors. You can daisy chain the e-stop remote and Ethernet cable. And as well, on the lower power projectors, you can also daisy chain the power. Now that our laser projector is powered on and ready for control, we can install QuickShow software on our PC. To download the software, go to pangolin.com/downloads and download QuickShow full version. Once downloaded, run the installer and follow the install wizard. While that is installing, grab the included Ethernet cable and plug one end into your PC's Ethernet port or into a switch, and the other end into the Ethernet port on the back of your projector. Now, using the FP4 control hardware on the back of the laser projector, press down on the dial to light up the display. We need to ensure the following. First, make sure that under operational mode, Beyond/QS is checked. Then, under network setup, make sure auto IP is checked. Lastly, under scan guard, make sure scan guard is disabled. Now you want to go ahead and run our QuickShow software. Since our hardware is now connected to the PC, QuickShow should open. The first time you open QuickShow, it will prompt you to go through a first-time setup wizard. Feel free to click whichever type of user you are. Beginner is a good place to start if you're new. You can always change it later. Next, select high-performance scanners. All Kvant laser systems are high-performance in this case. Then, select 3 laser RGB projector. And lastly, click analog color system. Now that we have set up an established connection with QuickShow, you can create your content you intend to upload. There's many ways for you to create content for different needs. We suggest you watch many of our tutorial videos on content creation on YouTube to help you create exactly what you need, and instead we'll focus on how to actually get content on your projector to automatically play. Now let's say we have a logo projection, and this is our logo here. Let's schedule this to run from 8 p.m. to 12 a.m. every night. With our projector installed, we'll connect QuickShow and create a zone for where our projection will go. We will just call this logo and set this zone up in real life where we want the logo to go. Then we'll go to the logo in the workspace we have created and assign that logo to that zone. If we play that cue from this PC, it should look exactly how you want it to look once it's installed and running automatically. Now let's export. Go to File, FP4 Export, and for this application, we'll go to Auto Daily Schedule. Other options for export are similar with just a few different options depending on what you want to do. Now we can drag that logo we created into the right from the left and assign a start time of 20 hours, 0 minutes, 0 seconds, and run it until 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds. Click Export and save to a file. Follow the wizard. Click Apply Color, Size, Geometric Correction, and bam. This will copy that zone we did a moment ago to the projector. Then we'll click Content Intended to be Used on Specific Projectors and select the connected FP4. Click Next and select Export to a connected FP4. And we can choose where we will export locally. Then upload to folder 1, click Next, and this renders the cues and uploads them to the projector. Finally, let's do a couple last things to the projector itself. go to File, FP4 Settings, and this will open a digital terminal for your FP4. Then we will set it to Autoplay Mode. Then on the right, scroll down to Autoplay Mode Settings. This should be selected onto List and Loop. List number being the one we explored to before, which is folder 1. Below that, you should set the clock time. You can set it to sync to your PC, and note that the FP4, to maintain time even when powered off, the FP4 has to have a battery installed. If it does have a battery installed, it'll let you know here. Then you can disconnect your PC from the projector and it'll follow the schedule we uploaded. We hope you have a great experience using your new Kvant projector in auto mode. If you still have questions, feel free to email our support line at support@pangolin.com, and we can help you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching.